Okay, Intervoice, that's an organization that tries to help emancipate voice hearers, because we think voice hearing is a normal experience, and when you pathologize it, then the outcome is really bad. But when you support people to live with their voices, to learn to cope with their voices, then the outcome is just another human being with all kinds of capacities. So we try to deliver hopeful messages and try to connect people who hear voices and people they are related to. We try to support self-help, because we think that, and we showed that it helped indeed when people have the same experience and share their experiences and talk about their experiences. We try to facilitate research, user-led or user-informed research, because it's important that voice hearers make their own questions and not dictated by professionals. For example, I read an article of a famous researcher who did research on hearing voices, and she said, before my pension, I want to get rid of these voices. That's not the way we think about voices. Voices is a part of our society and is a part of a human experience. We deliver, or we stimulate training. I will tell you something about that. And we try to follow the media and to influence the media. That about Intervoice. I will tell you something about how this movement, this International Hearing Voices Network, which is not an institute, but it's a living organism, how this started. It started with the work of Roman Escher. I will also tell you something about the construct. This is something that Marius Rom developed in order to give meaning, to make sense of personal voices. And I will tell you how we do that. Yesterday I heard that an article I wrote together with Eleanor Longdon about 100 voice hearers is accepted for publication, so I'm really glad to tell you about that. I will briefly tell you something about the Talking with Voices approach and about how we train professionals and voice hearers in coping with voices. We'll tell you something about the activities of the Hearing Voices Networks, and I try to say something about our work and Julian Jaynes. The first thing I think is, I wrote there authorization. I think that's a very important concept that Julian Jaynes mentioned. Because when people are authorized to hear voices, that makes a big difference when they are authorized to be schizophrenic and hearing voices. That makes a complete different identity. But first, I want to tell a story from my practice. We organize regular Dutch Hearing Voices conferences, and every year a woman approached me and she asked me questions just about voices. And the third year, she